There's an intense argument you're having with yourself first and then presenting it before society. It's a process, journey, and you're a passenger. In my work, when everyone is seeing hyperrealism, I think I'm looking at abstraction. You love something so much that you hardly see anything else, and the end result keeps you going. But eventually I'm realizing it is the process which is more important, and the result is just an outcome. The key is to dive deeper than just superficial wonderings, and that is difficult to achieve. I think when you know your calling and you're passionate about it, you see it clearly, and then it's just walking towards it. I suggest being minimal in one's approach, so you're not walking with the burden and getting tired of your own journey. For artists, every day is a lockdown and studio becomes a space for isolation. My world is planned keeping my art practice as a center, and whatever I do is mostly driven by this central idea, and that's how I spend longer time on my work. I'm realizing it is a process which is more important, and result is just an outcome. I have renounced some part of mundane things, and I had the same routine during lockdown as before. This lockdown, if it has contributed or helped me in any way, is that it has given me an affirmation of the small world I carry around me, and that is enough to move ahead. And this is not a flaw. I can spend longer time on my work because my world is planned keeping my art practice as a center. It is basically helpful to keep obstacles aside, and whatever I do is mostly driven by this central idea. Discipline and persuasion are key elements. That's what I honestly feel. Just keep on fighting and there's no plan B. I think in my initial stage of practice, I was passionate, focused, but not so clear about my choices and path I was trying to find. And the kind of practice I'm doing currently is making more sense to me. I'm clear of what I wish to do and explore. And this time it is not trying, it is doing. Advice to young practitioners would be, firstly, you really need to understand yourself. Then only it can start. I would say initially do a lot of experiments, see what interests you, keep pushing, find your own method, and accept that your practice may not follow current trends, and eventually you have to allow yourself to be you.